This video is an example of finding a percentage of area under the standard normal curve. What percentage of the area under the normal curve is between the following two z-scores? My first z-score is -1.10, and my second z-score is 1.46. So what you want to do is you want to sketch the area that they're looking for. So I went ahead and drew a bell curve or a standard normal curve with a mean of 0. So I put 0 in the middle. The horizontal axis is a real number line. So a z-score of -1.10 will be to the left of 0. And then my second z-score is 1.46. Now, because they're asking for a between situation, I'm going to shade between those two values. If they asked for the area greater than 1.46 and less than -1.10, I would be shading those two outer tails instead. Now I'm going to do this two ways. I'm going to use a standard normal table and then also the TI-84 calculator. If you don't have a TI-84 calculator, then an easy way to handle a problem like this is to use a standard normal table. All right, so to use a standard normal table, I'm actually going to have to use it twice because a standard normal table reads cumulatively. In other words, it's expecting an area from negative infinity up to a z-score. The table doesn't give an in-between case. So I'm going to have to deconstruct this bell curve into two bell curves. One with a larger area, and then one with a smaller area shaded, and I'm going to subtract out the tail, this lower tail that I don't want. Okay, so doing that, again, I drew a bell curve and I shaded this larger cumulative area from negative infinity up to positive 1.46. That's this larger area. And then I want to subtract out this smaller area because I don't want this tail. So again, it's this larger area subtracting out the piece we don't want. Going to the standard normal table for this first larger area, I expect it to be greater than 0.5 because I've shaded over half of this bell curve. Half of the area is from negative infinity up to 0, so it's going to be half the area plus this little bit more. Again, I'm not expecting an area less than 0.5 or 50% for this one. Now, in a standard normal table, the z-scores are on the outside, broken into two pieces. We have the units in 10th place along this first column and the hundredths place across this first row, and I need to intersect those. So for this first z-score of positive 1.46, okay, I'm going to read down to 1.4 and over to 0.06. So that first area is 0.9279. Okay, that's this piece right here. Oops, I think I copied it wrong. 1.469279. Okay, just double checking. Sorry about that. And then using the table again for this negative z-score, I want to go to the page that indicates z is below 0. Okay, so these are all negative z-scores on the second page. I want to go down to -1.1 and then over to 0.00. Again, you can see that across the top. It's hard to fit this all in the camera. Okay, so that little left tail area that I'm going to be subtracting out is 0.1357. All right, so that's how I get 0.1357 here. Okay, doing that subtraction, okay, that's not going to be the answer. Doing that subtraction, I get a between area of 0.7922, or as a percent, that's going to be 79.22%. Okay, that's how you use a table, a standard normal table. It's a little bit clunky, but it gets the job done. If you have a TI-84 calculator, it's pretty straightforward. Okay, a couple of things to keep in mind. Okay. All right. The place you want to go on a TI-84 calculator is this distribution function or menu right here. It's right above this vars key. So pressing second and the vars button, that'll get me to my distribution menu. And option two is normal CDF, normal cumulative distribution function. Okay, I'm going to select that. It defaults to the calculator's version of negative infinity. Okay, so just like how the table theoretically starts at negative infinity, or the curve starts, quote unquote, at negative infinity, the calculator approximates that as negative 1 times 10 to the 99th power. You could type in negative 1 and a bunch of zeros and that would be just fine if your calculator doesn't default to that. Okay, that would be for finding an area from negative infinity up to a z-score. Your lower bound would be negative infinity, your upper bound would be 1.46. Here, your lower bound would be negative infinity and your upper bound would be negative 1.10. With the calculator, however, you can do an in-between case just by putting in your lower bound and upper bound. We have a lower bound of negative 1.10, upper bound of negative 1.46. So putting that in, and you want to leave these two numbers as is if you're working with z-scores or a standard normal situation. The mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1 for the standard normal distribution. And then I'm going to arrow down, enter, and enter again. And rounding to 4 decimal places, you'll see that I get 0.7922, which is the same value that I got when I used the standard normal table.